What's going on, people? My name is Jack. My headphones are falling, and I haven't even started the video for less than 10 seconds. What's going on with my day? Coronavirus is infecting my headphones as well as the population. Thank you guys for tuning in to another video today. My name is Jack. I produce weekly content based around video editing, videography, and how to make money making videos. Subscribe if that sounds interesting to you. Today, I'm going to walk through how I edit my club videos, my after movies, my recap videos, all the names for the same exact thing. Without further ado, let's break it down. I'm going to actually show you guys a live Premiere Pro project for my most recent edit. I went to Manchester. I filmed Nelly, probably one of the most legendary rappers of all time. Oh, an old school guy for sure, but definitely a legend. And, you know, shot the place up in Manchester and had a blast. Put together arguably, not arguably, 100% my best after movie yet. Really, really good piece of work. And overall, I'm going to break it down and break the timeline down for you essentially. So, on the screen right now is my Adobe Premiere Pro project. Let me actually just go over here and turn off this this light, because it's just wasting battery at the end of the day, right? We got a light here, all right? I'm lit up. You can't complain. There's still light at the end of the day. There's light at the end of the tunnel. There's light at the end of the screen. I'm going to go ahead and throw my my headphones on. And essentially, I'm going to break this down. Now, an after movie for me comes in a couple different parts. It's not, there's not like 100% of structure I stick to every time, but there's a couple kind of more or less fundamental things that I do every time. The first thing that I do is I actually import all my footage over here and I organize it. So as you see here, if you actually scroll through from clip one all the way to, you know, I have 270 clips or something like that here, all of them are named. And if you click on them, they all have in and out points, right? So I can click on bottles, for example, and I know that my clip starts at a actual good point. Now, in and out points, if you do not know, I assume probably you do, but if you don't know, you can click a clip and bring it up into your source viewer up here in Premiere. And if the clip starts at the beginning, you can actually play the clip. That one's actually got music, that's a little bit annoying, right? But you can play the clip. And for example, you see how here, I'm literally looking at my feet the whole time, and then all of a sudden here, I actually pan up. And I actually go to this guy right here. I can actually just press I, and it will in, and the clip will only start from right there. So if I import the clip to my timeline, it will only start from the actual good point. So I go through every single one of my clips, 270 clips. It takes me a couple hours right away after I've shot the club, and I actually click on the clip, double click it, I load it up, and I press an in point, an I point, and then sometimes if there's a set point where I want it to end, I'll also press O, and that's an out point. So I organize my clips right off the bat instantly, and I name them. Also, I don't change the number, so they stay in order. If I was to call this just Henny Golden, it wouldn't be in order. It wouldn't be after CO159. It would just be lost. It would be random. So if you just change the name and take away the number, the order of the clips actually loses, which to me, that's important. I want to actually sort of edit stuff from sort of low level night up until like the hypest point, which means I want stuff in order, right? I want it to get hyper and hyper as it goes, essentially. And also, I just want to know where stuff's at. If I'm like, oh, I shot that one girl at about 12 p.m., let me go find, that's probably around 100, you know what I mean? So I want to have the order. So that's something I'd advise you guys to do, is if when you're renaming the clips, do not change the actual number. Just click it and write something next to the actual name of the clip so it stays in order. So organization right away. Now, compilation comes next, obviously. Once you've gone through all of your clips, you can start compiling. However, before I start compiling, what I do is I actually get my song, right? So for this, it's Hot in Here by Nelly. And what I actually do is I drag and drop it. I find the actual drop where I want it to drop on. Now, funny enough, with this, I don't even want it to drop until like a minute into it or something like that, right? The drop isn't even until about a minute and 5 seconds. Like that. I said it's getting hot in here. There's a whole buildup of like a minute of the song before that. And that's the bit no anyone even cares about, right? That's the Nelly Hot in Here. That's the hook, right? That's what we wanted to start from. So what I did is I actually took a little bit, like maybe a five or 8 seconds of the actual intro. And I put that as the intro because it's more mellow. Hot in. So as you see right here at the beginning, I took 8 seconds of the intro of the song and built a nice little intro. So you can watch this. And then I actually start the drop after that intro right there. And that drop doesn't even come to about a minute and 6 seconds or something. So I actually made sure to find the absolute hypest part of it and make that start right off the bat. Obviously, that's pretty pretty obvious, right? You obviously want to start it from the drop and have literally 5 to 10 seconds of intro. No more than 10 seconds. Definitely no more than 10 seconds. You want to get straight in. You want to suck that viewer in and then basically just slap them in the face with the edit. So intro, I've pretty much realized that if you focus on making an amazing intro, the rest of the edit could be okay and it'll still be perceived as a phenomenal video because the intro just hit them so hard and impressed them right away. The edit, in this case, is still really, really good, but at the end of the day, in my opinion, phenomenal intro, okay edit, phenomenal outro is a is a doable strategy. Now, next up, the compilation, right? I just start putting stuff in, obviously. If we actually give this a play, what I want to do is I actually want to just go ahead and turn the volume down a bit. This is a bit too much in my ear. As we see right here, you know, I've compiled everything, put stuff together, and the next stage is I do stuff at the same time, right? So at the same time as I'm compiling my clips, I'm also doing my sound design, and I'm also doing a little bit of color grading, because funny enough, even though you should technically do the color grading at the end, just to for lag issues, I always have a adjustment layer with my color grade running over the top that I'm sort of turning on and off throughout my project. So if it does get a bit laggy, I just toggle it off, right? But overall, I like to see what the final colors are going to look like throughout my project. So I am more or less always having a an adjustment layer running across the top so I can see the colors, right? The colors are pretty significantly different when you're actually using the color grade. So I want to see what the finals are going to look like. And also that helps me make clips look a little bit more similar and stuff. Sometimes you got to color correct some clips to make them look similar. But overall, that right there is essentially the organization, compilation, and now it's really just the edit itself, which is the overlays, effects, stuff like that. That sort of comes up next. And again, like sort of the next three things I do at the same time, like I just said. I do color grading, sound design, and overlays and effects, more or less, or overlays and filters, more or less as I work my way through it. Instead of just coming back and doing the sound design for everything after I built the project, again, I want to see what the final results are looking like. I like to complete a section as I work through. So what I actually do is I more or less tend to do all the sound design, the overlays and filters and color grading as I work through at the same time, when that's not the most common thing. Now, the next thing that I like to throw in there, right, is what you just saw right there, these two shots right here. These are parallax effects. So what I did is I actually got the pictures from the photographer who was at the event, and I took his pictures and I loaded it up in Photoshop, chopped out all the actual elements and then animated them in After Effects. I followed a specific tutorial for that. I'm going to link the tutorial down below by R7 Visuals, something like that. Dude's a beast. My bad for messing up his name, but the dude's a beast. I'm going to link his tutorial down below. And I watched his tutorial. It was absolutely fucking awesome, basically. And essentially, the way I edit club videos is organization, compilation, overlays, filters, sound design, color grading. That's basically it. Now, sound design is really important. I want to actually mute my song, and I just want to play my project with only the sound design layers turned on. And this right here is a healthy sound design right here. What I've tried to do is try to create a sound for every single visual, which once you've actually thrown the track over it, they blend together super nicely. But this is what just the raw audio sounds like, and this is what sort of a successful sound design should sound like, I guess. There should be a specific sound for each element in your video. Let's go. As you see, there's a sound for everything. If something happens, there's a sound. And the sounds sound a little bit crazy because there's no song. But once you've blended it in behind a song, and these are just in the background, it works out perfectly. As you see, that sounded wild, right? And just like that. And just like that, what I've done as well at the end is I've sort of put a little like offset effect on the actual song just to sort of have that same song, but I've got the bandpass audio filter on there so it sounds kind of in the distance, if you hear. So it sort of sounds in the distance, and what I've done is I've had some sound effects, which are like some cinematic booms and shit to leave them wanting more, all right? Now, if we turn the actual song back on and play this, you see that those effects blend so well together in the background when they sound crazy on their own. Let's play.
Oh, it's getting hot in here. So, hot. So take off all your clothes.
A little bit.
Get off the freeway, exit 106 and parked it. Ashtray, good day, time to spark it. Gucci collar for dollar, got out and walked it. I speak English, baby, I can't talk it.
Boom, not too shabby at all. Now, there is a sort of a transitions, right? The transition sort of stuff. A couple of these are pre-made transitions. This right here, stuff like that, that is After Effects transition packs, right? It's a folder or After Effects project. You load it up, you put your couple clips in there, it does some crazy transitions for you, right? So those are pre-made transitions, but the transitions that blend this together super well is the overlays and filters, which I've sort of used as transitions. These ones right here. Now, if I play this, you might not even notice it, but I'll play it.
So take off all your clothes.
They are these right off the top, these light leaks. What I've done is I've gotten these light leaks, which are the same color as the color grade of the background, right? This sort of orangey light leaks. And I'm actually going to turn this down again so I can break this down. And what I've done is I've literally just sort of put them at their absolute max point, right? Which is there when it's filling the screen. I've put that at the point where the clips change color, so or change clip, right? So it sort of looks like this light sort of explodes. And they're not obvious enough that you sort of are aware it's a different layer. You sort of blends together because of the same color and looks like it is, essentially part of the scene. And that right there is really, really subtle. And also it blends stuff super well together. Like what I'll do is I'll take off those layers and you can watch this now without that. You see? Very, very plain, honestly. Just the simple addition of some light leaks over the top, acting as transitions essentially, blends this together. The viewer isn't so aware that there's a hard cut right there. A hard cut is when it just switches. Now, these are all hard cuts. All of them just change. But because of the use of the light leaks, what we're doing right here is we're blending it together. Essentially, as an editor, you're a wizard. You're tricking the viewer. The viewer thinks something crazy's happened there, but all that's happened right there is a fucking light leak plays, right? You're essentially trying to trick the viewer. You want to make it seamless. You want to make it look like some crazy shit happened right there, but without even doing too crazy stuff, right? And overall, that right there is pretty much how I edit my after movies, aka recap videos, aka club after movies. The actual link to this project is going to be down below in the description if you want to watch it yourself, whatever the case may be. But to conclude, a phenomenal, phenomenal after movie, if I do say so myself, has a couple elements. First, organizing so you actually know what you're doing. My organization strategy is recommending that you guys name the clips and in and out them. And also, don't get rid of the number so you know the order of the clips. You know what happened first, what happened last. Compilation, obviously, building the whole thing. And along the way, I'm also doing the sound design, the overlays and filters, and the color grading, and also throwing some advanced effects in there. Pretty much every project, I use After Effects to complement it with at least one little advanced effect. The only thing we did in After Effects here was the animated pictures, which worked super well. And the thing is that looks like it could just be super slow-mo, right? Like to the untrained eye, you don't know whether it's super slow-mo or an effect. So when I blend super slow-mo in here later on at 120 frames a second, like around here, right? It makes the effect even nicer because I've got what is perceived as maybe super slow-mo and then actually slow-mo, which is 120 isn't even super slow-mo. It's not fucking a million frames a second or whatever. But at the end of the day, it is slow, four times slower than the normal speed. And that right there is my club after movies. Oh my god, I'm jumping back over here. My light, oh no, wait, I think I can turn the light on. I don't even have to manually do it. There you go, boom, it's a win. Hell yeah, thank you guys for tuning in. Tell me if that was a little bit more drawn out than you thought it was. I felt like I could have just talked a bit too much and rambled, so tell me. Jack, you fucking rambled. This could have been a good video, but you rambled, and you need to do a more precise bullet-pointed video of how you edit your club videos. That is actually a thought in my mind right now that I might need to do, but I've been known to think I talk too much when I actually explain things perfectly. So it could be either one. Tell me if I sucked, tell me if I actually delivered, and I will take it on board. Thank you guys for watching the video. That is how I edit my Club After Movies, aka recap videos. Filmed 50 plus different live events since I was 17 years old. I was in the club at 17. I had to get in on a fake ID to film a club. I was filming for my fucking drug dealer when I started filming. Hilarious. But thank you guys for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed. And overall, that is my refined process after 50 plus different clubs and different venues that I've filmed of how I edit my Club After Movies, club recap videos, club promo video. I don't know. All of the above. Thank you guys for watching. I've been Jack, or at It's Jack Co on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. Follow me on whatever one is the best for you. Have a nice day. See you later. Peace out.